Our special guest is the star in a fictional story about a real guy. I think that's a fair way of describing it. Jack Black?
Yeah, that's exactly right. You nailed it. No one said it exactly quite like that.
Really?
I appreciate you. Because, yeah, I play R.L. Stine, who is the actual author of the Goosebumps franchise of books. But I don't play him like the real Stine. The real Stine is a sweet guy.
Have you met him?
Yes.
Has he seen the film?
Yes, he loved the film.
Good.
And that was very important to me, more important than all the critics. But when I met him, it was, kind of a test to see, am I going to base the character on the actual R.L. Stine? And I knew immediately that I couldn't, because the R.L. Stine that I play in the film is a very antisocial, kind of prickly dude.
Yeah.
Kind of mean.
Yeah, well, the first time we really see you is when you're shouting at the new neighbor through the fence, through the window.
Well, it seems like I'm going to be the villain,
that
I'm going to be the baddie, but it turns out that he's just misunderstood.
Yes, he is. R.L. Stine, they describe him as the Stephen King of kids' literature. He sold 400 million books, and that's not just the domestic market.
Impressive. You know, there's only one other author of children's literature that sold that many. And it happens to be someone with two letters before the name. Is that a coincidence?
Probably.
J.K. Rowling.
Exactly. Potter
if
books.
You please. I'm thinking about starting my name with two letters.
Wasn't the person that did 50 Shades of Grey two letters as well? Your faces in this film, as in all your films, are incredible. And as you just alluded, you play a bit of a villain to start and then you turn into the goodie. We're recording this. It doesn't really work on radio. But give us your best villain face. It's good.
No, it's not. Hold on. Let me work on this.
Okay.
Let me think about it. You're right. This is an odd thing to do for the radio. hold on. Let's pause for 30 seconds while Jack prepares an awesome face. No, that wasn't very good.
That was awesome. I look good from this angle. Come and film it from this angle. It looks better from
this
angle. Yes. Now turn into a goodie. Do a goodie face.
Oh. This is ridiculous.
So sweet. Just tell us about Goosebumps. Give us a 20-second kind of sell on the film.
Okay, so it's about R.L. Stine, the author. He's a recluse, and all of his monsters that he's ever written and created escape from his books. And the whole movie is about him and some kids from the neighborhood recapturing the monsters and putting them back in the books from whence they came.
That's a very good description of the movie.
Did that go over 20 seconds?
Perfect. That's 20 spot on.
Incredible pressure.
Do you know, they never say work with kids or animals. How about monsters? There must be a lot of CGI in that. Was it the tennis ball thing?
I say always work with monsters.
Oh, do you?
They're the best. This is really a monster movie. Primarily, they're the stars of the film. And we have the best ones.
Mm.
Our director was like in love with monsters and was a brilliant CGI animator guy. So, yeah, I think people will flip out. If you like monsters, you're going to love
you will
Goosebumps.
Yeah, a serious actor question. What's it like? Because obviously they're not there. Is it difficult to act to a tennis ball on a stick or whatever it was?
Well, I got lots of practice because I did King Kong.
Yes.
And there was tons of acting to nothing in that. Although Andy Serkis did sometimes show up in his, suit of ping pong balls. But it doesn't have the... quite the terrifying effect that I think he intended.
No.
That's what acting's all about. From when you're a little kid, you pretend like there's monsters and things that are not really there. So it's very, very much what I've been doing since I was 6 years old.
As you said, stars of this film are the monsters and you and a cast of young, up-and-coming actors.
Yeah.
A bit like in School of Rock. Do you like working with young actors and teaching them their profession a bit,
Well, you
maybe.
Know, School of Rock, you mentioned, was the first movie that I did that was like a kid's genre movie, really. And I was worried, I was concerned that, what if I'm not good with the kids? What if they don't like me? What if this is a bad idea? But once I got on the set and we started making the movie, I was like, this is very natural. And this felt like I was meant to do it. I think my sense of humor meshes well with kid sense. Yeah. I'm kind of like a big kid.
Who's your favorite Goosebumps monster?
I have to say Slappy.
You voice Slappy.
I do voice Slappy. And he's a ventriloquist dummy, but don't call him a dummy.
Do not call him a dummy.
And he's kind of the mastermind of all of the Goosebumps monsters. He's a brilliant, pure, evil menace.
Mm. That was a good impression of Slappy there. Yeah, you went into slappy mode.
I gave you a little taste of slappy.
A little taste of slappy there. We just mentioned about some of the films you've done. Would you ever want to do a space movie? I'm very into space at the moment because we've got our first kind of astronaut up there spinning around at 17,500 miles an hour as we speak.
No
in the
kidding.
International Space Station. Tim
this
Peake.
Is the first one.
It's the first Brit to do a space walk.
Congratulations.
Yeah, we're all very excited about this.
It's
goes
about
past
time.
Every morning and we wave to him.
We've been sending him up there since the 60s.
I know. And your parents were satellite engineers
on the
Hubble Space Telescope. That's cool.
Yeah.
Isn't it?
It's a proud achievement.
Yeah. Would you like to do a space movie?
I am interested in sci-fi. Mm. It's actually my favorite genre. I love to read sci-fi books and watch the movies. If there could be a funny space movie, I'd be in there. Mm. Absolute. You got any ideas?
No. Maybe we could write one.
Space rock. Space. Bumps.
Space rock, space bump rock.
We'll work on it.
Yeah, we'll figure it out. Jack Black, thank you so much for coming in this morning.
Thank you.